Good evening, everyone. My name is Massimiliano Alfano, and I'm a PhD student from the University of Verona. Today, I'm going to present our new study where we used the Cas9 targeted sequencing data for de novo assembly of a region of interest. As proof of principle case, we took a genomic region in Phacelus vulgaris that has been associated to pod shuttering. This region was identified in a genome-wide association study by comparing recombinant in red lines with shuttering or non-shuttering phenotype derived from the cultivar Midas. The region is 250 kb long and it's located at the end of chromosome 5. Now, in order to study more in details which are the genes and variants responsible for the shuttering phenotype within this region, we wanted to perform deep sequencing of different shuttering and non-shuttering lines. So in order to do so, we generated Illumina whole genome sequencing data. However, upon aligning those data on the P. vulgaris reference genome, we found that our sample probably differed very much from P. vulgaris, as in this region you can see here, we found low quality mapping position as well as poorly structured variants. So we expected here inaccurate genotyping, and what we concluded was that we needed a cultivar-specific genome for fine variant mapping. However, the de novo assembly of a cultivar-specific genome can be costly as well as time-consuming. Here, we tested the possibility to use Cas9 targeted sequencing as an alternative to canonical nanopore full genome sequencing for the de novo assembly of a region of interest, and to do so, we tested both approaches in parallel. On the left here, we went for canonical nanopore full genome sequencing and then assembled de novo a new reference genome. On the right, we excised the region of interest with Cas9, sequenced with nanopores, and then performed de novo assembly only on the region of interest. Now, since our region was 250 kb long, we had to plan a Cas9 tiling approach to capture the entire region. Using this approach, the target is subdivided into smaller overlapping subregions, which are excised using two separate cut pools, as shown here. To cover the whole region, we design a total of 10 guide RNAs excising 5 50 kb subregions. Those subregions overlapped for about 3 kb and, in some cases, spanned structural variants. We design guide RNAs making sure that our guides fed on conserved coding portions, containing neither SNPs nor indels. Cas9-mediated targeted enrichment was tested on nuclear high-molecular-weight genomic DNA, and actually, as you can see here, it worked very well. Sequencing data was all concentrated on the region of interest, which allowed to cover the whole region very well. Only minimal sequencing, as shown here, was mapped outside of the region of interest. The coverage obtained on the whole region was very high, was actually more than enough. So we could move on with the de novo assembly of the region of interest. In these tables, we compare sequencing and de novo assembly statistics from whole genome and Cas9 targeted datasets. You can see here that Cas9 targeted sequencing generated 3 times higher coverage on the region of interest as compared to whole genome sequencing. Both datasets, on the other hand, allow to assemble the region of interest into a single counting containing no gaps. However, we needed 2 flow cells, 5 libraries, and a lot of sequencing time for full genome sequencing, as compared to Cas9 targeted sequencing, where only 1 flow cell and as few as 30 hours of sequencing were required to get the same results. In this graph, you can see the comparison of the two assemblies in the target region. The Cas9 counting shared 99.5% identity with the counting generated with traditional de novo assembly from whole genome sequencing data. The only little difference was due to low complexity regions, which were found to be repetitive ones, where we know that nanopore sequencing has some issues. We then checked whether mapping quality was actually improved. So Illumina data were aligned first on the new cultivar-specific reference genome generated using standard whole genome sequencing data, and second on the P. vulgaris reference, where the region of interest was replaced with the counting generated using Cas9 targeted enrichment data. And what you can see immediately here, is that the BAM files from the new assemblies are cleaner. Most of the structural variants, and then the single nucleotide variants region, disappeared. And indeed, the percentage of genotyped position increased from about 95% to 98%, and in some regions we observed even a more drastic improvement. And most notably, Cas9 with genome sequencing-mediated de novo assembly provided comparable improvements in mapping quality. So, to conclude, in this study we showed that Cas9 enrichment is a valid alternative to full genome sequencing for sample ultra-long targets of interest. Now, usually, a 20 kb target is recommended for Cas9-mediated targeted enrichment, but for very large regions we showed that even 50 kb was possible, of course provided that you have high molecular weight DNA. Also, the coverage throughout the region of interest was 3 times higher as compared to full genome sequencing. And last but not least, guide RNAs were designed on conserved shared regions, which means that one design can be applied to multiple recombinant inbred lines or cultivars. With this, I'd like to conclude my talk by thanking the group of Professor Papa from the Polytechnic University of Marche and then my group from the University of Verona, starting from Professor Massimo Delle Donne, who's the head of the lab, Professor Marzia Rossato, who's my PhD supervisor, and then a special thanks goes to Simone, Luca, Denise, Giovanni, and Barbara, who actively contributed